Cargo tanks are not frequently gas-free, and chief officers should make the best of every opportunity to verify that the cargo tank and its equipment are in good order. You could see my schematic route across the first stringer. A chief officer can use the chance of a shipyard period to photograph the critical equipment in each cargo tank. An album of these photographs is an invaluable reference when problems within tank equipment occur. I will show you only some sections of the cargo tank to minimize the timing of this video. Stress concentrations occur at abrupt change of section, sharp corners and openings. The degree of stress concentration is a function of the shape of the discontinuity. The stresses passing through the structure have to continue to the surrounding structure, otherwise there is a possibility of causing fractures at the location of discontinuity. We should check areas where there is a change of section for potential fractures. Reporting defects requires a clear description of the size and type of defect and its exact location in the tank. Owners should provide a book of laminated diagrams, including one diagram of each tank, to provide the officer responsible for tank inspections with a convenient way of accurately indicating defects. For example, imagine that I observed minor crack of the stiffener on the main bracket of the web frame. I give you an example of the recorded defect. Now I am moving down on the second stringer, and I will walk across the web frames, which is actually not so easy. Now I am moving down on the third stringer. I am walking down on the fourth stringer, and near the platform you could see the submerged fixed washing machine. I am moving down to the bottom of the tank. The main purpose of my inspection was to check the condition of 5 cm main cargo valve seat ring. This valve was dismantled and observed damage of the seat ring. Due to this fact, valve was passing cargo during loading discharging operations. The new seat ring was installed and the valve fixed back on its position. Then, position indicator of the valve should be verified for fully open and closed positions. The nuts should be checked for tightness and hydraulic pipes confirmed that no leakage exists. Also, it is important to examine valve suction bell mouths for foreign objects and rags. Now I'm going to check cargo pipelines, its flanges and flexible pipe couplings. Bulkhead glands of the pipelines should be examined at the forward part of the tank. Now you could see in the person manhole area. Each cargo tank has a manhole to rescue the injured person. This opening is large enough for a person to pass through and is also used as an access point for lowering down all necessary tools for the maintenance in the tank. Bracket tools are areas particularly defenseless for the flexing and stresses imposed on the hull structure. The new bolts of the pipelines should be examined for cracks or excessive corrosion, and if necessary should be replaced for the new one. And now I am going to leave the cargo tank.